Hello everyone, welcome to Lara Tips. In today's video, we'll be looking at 4 new things that are added to Laravel version 9.12. So let's get started. The first thing that has been added is this throw if method on the pending request class, which is the HTTP facade. If I just show you over here, this one. So before there was this only throw method and I'm sending request to this API users. If I just show you that over here in the API and here users, I am throwing this 433 or let's say 422 like this. It will throw an exception over here. But if I just go over here and let me not write throw and click on run, then it will return null for me. But actually this users was throwing an exception. So if I write here throw and then call JSON, then it will actually throw this exception, this request exception. But let's say we don't want to directly call this throw. We only want to see this exception under some condition. Then we have now this throw if method new. And if we pass here true, then I'll see the same exception. But if I just pass here false like this and reload, then it will just return null for me, which is as if we are not using throw. Now let me comment this out. And the second thing that has been added is this prevent stray request on the same HTTP facade, and it will be very useful whenever we are doing testing. Whenever we are testing, we don't want to send the HTTP request to this exact endpoint. We just want to fake the HTTP request, otherwise our test will be very slow. So for that case, this new prevent stray request has been introduced. Let me just uncomment this one. If I just write this and then if I call this HTTP, then it will give me exception. This is runtime exception with the message attempted request to this much without a matching fake. But if I just write this fake just before sending this, as I have said, this will be only useful whenever we are writing test. So if I write a fake like this and this HTTP response and the body over here, then if I just return, then it is showing me this okay. But actually let me just comment this thing and just return it, then actually the output is like this. But since we are faking it like this, so it threw okay. So this is the new thing that has been added. Now the third thing that has been added is this where not morph to, or where not morph to two methods. Now for that, let me show you over here. I have this posts, videos and comments. And these are related to each other by polymorphic relationship. A post can have many comments, and I think I need to zoom it for you guys. So I think it is okay. So for the post, you can see here post and comment ID. This commentable type over here, and this is commentable ID. And if I just show you over here in the post model, then you can see here morph many comment, and inside the comment we have this commentable like this. And if I go here in the Tinkerwell and let me just uncomment this, and before there was this where morph to method, we can see here this comment where morph to commentable. This commentable is name of this method. Okay, so here we'll write post. So whatever the comments that are related to this post, it would show this. So the comment related to the post one, it will show it like this. But now there is new method where not morph to, and if I just reload it, then I'll see this second lorem ipsum dollar sheet, which is actually the comment of the post 2. You can see here there is also another where not morph to, and you can easily use that by yourself. And finally, the fourth thing that has been added is this added ability to delay per channel based on the notification instance. And let me show you that over here in the Laravel news website. Before, whenever we wanted to delay a notification, then we could only pass delay here and we could only pass one carbon instance. But now we can pass here array like this, and it will delay each channels using this separate delay time. Before, if we had multiple channels, then it would delay all of them at the same time. But now we can have multiple delays. Similarly, we can have this method on the notification class, and then we can return it in the similar way as you have passed over here. And there are also many more other things that are added, and you can check this out in this laravelnews.com website. I'll be leaving the link of this website also just below that like button.